വേദാന്ത ത്രൂ സ്റ്റോറീസ് സ്റ്റോറി നമ്പർ 15. ദ ഡേഞ്ചർ ഓഫ് ഫ്ലാറ്ററി. എ ടീച്ചർ വൈൽ ഇൻസ്ട്രക്റ്റിംഗ് ഹിസ് സ്റ്റുഡൻസ് വാസ് ഡിസ്ക്രൈബിംഗ് ദ ഈവിൽ എഫക്ട്സ് ഓഫ് ഫ്ലാറ്ററി. ഹി സെഡ്, ഹാവ് യു നോട്ട് സീൻ എ കൈൻഡ് ഓഫ് ഫിഷ് വിച്ച് യു ക്യാൻ പഫ് അപ്പ് ബൈ ബ്ലോയിങ് ഇൻ ടു ഇറ്റ്സ് മൗത്ത്? ദ മോർ ഇറ്റ് ഈസ് ബ്ലോൺ ഇൻ ടു, ദ മോർ ഇറ്റ് സ്വെൽസ് ടിൽ എ ടൈം കംസ് വെൻ ഇറ്റ് ബേർസ് ആൻഡ് ഡൈസ്. Once upon a time, a king was invaded by his enemy. The matter was discussed for hours by his cabinet. Unfortunately, he had number of flatterers in his cabinet who assumed him that nothing could happen to him as he was very mighty king. The king felt so much flattered that he took no action or precaution, with the result that the enemy invaded his kingdom and, having conquered it, put him to an ignominious death. Vedanta True Stories, story number 14. Friend in Prosperity. Two friends, while on their way to a village, had to pass through a dense forest. There they suddenly came across a tiger. One of them immediately climbed a big tree which was near. But the other, not knowing how to climb a tree and suddenly remembering that a tiger would not touch a dead body, fell on the ground pretending that he was dead. The tiger came near the man lying motionless, smelt his body for a minute or so, and then went away. The man who had climbed the tree saw all this, and on coming down asked his friend what the tiger had whispered in his ears. His friend said, "The tiger asked me not to rely on a friend who can desert me at the approach of a danger." Vedanta True Stories, story number 13. The Ideal and the Real. Once upon a time, a king got a tank dug and desired that it should be a reservoir of milk. So he ordered all his subjects each to bring a seer of milk and pour it into the tank the next day. One of them thought that as everybody would be pouring his share of milk, it would not matter if he poured a seer of water and that he would not be detected. But the same thought arose in everybody else's mind also. When the king came in the evening of the next day, expecting to see the tank overflowing with milk, he found that it was full of water. Vedanta True Stories, story number 12. Why worldly people cannot attain God realization. Once upon a time, a devotee of God came to a saint of that locality and went on denouncing worldly people and their ways of life. The saint said, "Have you seen a crab? The mother crab gives birth to hundreds of small crabs and lives in a hole with her children. But she has to go out in search of food. She comes out of the hole but must, on account of the little ones, go into the hole again. Having given birth to hundreds of children, she has no energy or thought left for herself. Worldly people similarly have been engaged in various concerns, exhaust their minds. How can they pay attention to the realization of God? If any of them make an attempt, he is immediately overwhelmed by the demands of his worldly concerns and possessions. That's why it is difficult for worldly people to attain realization of God." Vedanta True Stories, story number 11. Self-defeating worldly hopes. A milkman, while going to the market to sell milk, became absorbed with the dreams of his future. He thought that with the profits he would purchase some ducks, that the ducks would give birth to a number of ducklings, which he might be able to sell for sufficient profit to enable him to invest in a cow. The cow would calve a number of times within a few years and would thus enable him to purchase a horse and even an elephant. And as he made the appropriate movements with his body, the milk pot slipped from his head and broke into pieces. Thus all his hopes were shattered like the pot. Vedanta True Stories. Story number 10. The Dishonest Miser. There was a miserly merchant who had amassed an immense fortune. He was extremely self-centered and kept very little touch with other members of the society. He had a daughter who had attained marriageable age, but he found it impossible to get the necessary ceremonies of the marriage accomplished without the help of other people. He saw the leaders of society and proposed that he would feed all people for 2 days on the occasion of his daughter's marriage and ask them to prepare the details of the dishes that should be prepared on the occasion. He next proposed that as everybody would be busy on the day of the marriage, the feeding of the people should commence on the day after the marriage. The marriage was duly celebrated when the people who attended were treated to pan supari and bidis. A few days later, some of the leaders came to see him and say they raised the question of feeding the people. When the merchant said that he would think about it as soon as all the ceremonies are over and subsequent to the marriage were over. After the last of such ceremonies were over, nothing, however, was done by the merchant for months. One day, as he returned from the market, some young persons met him and asked when he intended to give the promised feast. They did not get any satisfactory answer, and afterwards, discussions and arguments arose between them. The young man became incensed by the merchant's attitude and at length started giving him blows. With each blow, they asked him, "How now?" The merchant replied, "What of it? Will the blows which you are landing bring you anything? Whose money is saved, yours or mine?" Vedanta True Stories. Story number 9. Indiscriminate Charity. Once a thief, needing some implements with which he could carry on his profession, assumed the garb of a very poor man and, going to the house of a charitable person, asked for 10 rupees. As the householder was not in the habit of inquiring for what purposes an applicant required money, he gave the thief 10 rupees. The thief then went to the market and purchased the implements he needed. In course of time, he successfully committed many thefts and burglaries. It was discovered that the cause of all the crimes committed by the thief was the generous gift received from this charitable person. Thus, indiscriminate charity led to evil results. Vedanta True Stories. Story number 8. Prayer with a Reservation. A poor man was praying intently to the Mother Goddess, saying, "O great Mother, if thou givest me a rupee, I shall give thee half the amount." He went on saying his prayers aloud from place to place. At last he chanced upon a half rupee coin lying on the road, picked it up and said, "O Mother, thou art clever, for thou hast already kept thy half of the rupee and send me the other half." Vedanta True Stories. Story number 7. Incurable Habit. Once upon a time, a number of fisherwomen on their way back home were caught in a stormy rain, and they sought shelter in a garden full of roses. As night came on, they lay down for a sleep on the veranda of a cottage in the garden. But they found that the smell of roses, which was strong, prevented their sleep. About midnight, they got up and, taking their fish baskets, soaked them in the rain water and placed them as near their noses as possible. The baskets gave out the powerful fishy odor to which they were accustomed, and thereafter they fell into sound sleep. Vedanta True Stories. Story number 6. Unpractical Intellectuality. Two friends once went out to see a mango orchard. On entering the gay garden, they saw many beautiful creepers, fine trees full of ripe fruits and well-grown plants. One of them, being of a calculating turn of mind, went on counting the number of leaves and the number of branches on each tree and the number of fruits and so forth. The other, who was an epicure, went to a tree with ripe mangoes and started plucking and eating them to his heart's content. The gardener meanwhile discovered the entry of the two persons, and coming near them, asked them to leave the garden immediately. The second man, who had eaten as many mangoes as he could desire, left immediately. The other hesitated to leave the place because he had not finished his calculations. He had to be forcibly ejected by the gardener from the garden. Vedanta True Stories. Story number 5. Cleverer Than I. In a school for problem children, guardians were provided for the different classes of children that had to be dealt with. One particularly different boy, once escaping the notice of his teacher, started throwing stones at a big glass case belonging to the school. The glass case was at some distance, and the boy, though he tried several times, did not succeed in hitting it. His teacher found him engaged in this mischievous activity, and seeing what he was aiming at, he also picked up a stone and threw it at the glass, which was completely smashed by the impact. The boy, surprised, looked back and found that it was his teacher who had thrown the stone, which had smashed the glass. He understood that his teacher could be his teacher even in mischief, and that he did not want forcibly to restrain him in any act, but to help him as much as possible. And since then, he became one of the best behaved boys of the school. Vedanta True Stories. Story number 5. Cleverer Than I. In a school for problem children, guardians were provided for the different classes of children that had to be dealt with. One particularly different boy, once escaping the notice of his teacher, started throwing stones at a big glass case belonging to the school. The glass case was at some distance, and the boy, though he tried several times, did not succeed in hitting it. His teacher found him engaged in this mischievous activity, and seeing what he was aiming at, he also picked up a stone and threw it at the glass, which was completely smashed by the impact. The boy, surprised, looked back and found that it was his teacher who had thrown the stone, which had smashed the glass. He understood that his teacher could be his teacher even in mischief, and that he did not want forcibly to restrain him in any act, but to help him as much as possible. And since then, he became one of the best behaved boys of the school. Vedanta through stories. Story number 21. A man got tired of the world and wanted to lead a life of renunciation. He went to a hermitage and, going up to the head of the institution, inquired how he could join it. The head of the hermitage said, "There are two classes of people living here. The preceptors of gurus, the preceptors or gurus who could teach and guide the disciples, and the disciples who are to obey and follow the teachings of the gurus. Which of the two classes do you want to join?" The man said, with folded hands and with all appearance of humility, "May I be admitted to the class of preceptors?" Vedanta through stories. Story number 4. Adoption of a son. A man who was immensely wealthy, not being blessed with a son, was anxious to adopt a son who would inherit all his wealth. When his desire for adoption came known, many candidates called at his house, and each of them related the merits he possessed and the advantages the wealthy man would derive by adopting him. One of the candidates was an octogenarian who had not only a son and a grandson, but a great-grandson also. The wealthy man and others seated with him, when the old man appeared for interview, expressed their surprise that such an old man wanted to be adopted. The old man, however, said, "Sir, if you adopt me, it would be the best thing possible. You are now worrying as to who should inherit your wealth. But if you adopt me as your son, you will not have to worry for 3 generations to come, for I am a great grandfather in the direct line." Vedanta through stories. Story number 22. Apparent and real. A fisherman repeatedly cast his net in a tank, but all his attempts to catch fish ended in failure. He was surprised to find that as soon as he prepared to cast his net, all the fish withdrew from the water round about him. The next day, he again went to the tank and found a monk with his ochre-colored robe bathing in it and a large number of fishes playing around him. He thought that it was the ochre-colored garb that had attracted the fish, and putting on such a robe, went into the water. When he found that the fishes came near and played around him, he asked himself that if the mere fact of his personating of a sadhu had such an effect, how great would be the consequences of his becoming a real sadhu. This reflection brought about a change in his mind, and he gave up the fisherman's life and took to the way of religion. Ultimately, he became a saint.